Hey guys, Zack Morris here. Welcome back to The Wolf Among Us. Final episode, my friends. It's the last one. Last time we played episode 4 in Sheep's Clothing. This time we're playing episode 5, Cry Wolf. You know it's going to be a good episode because Bigby's in full wolf form, which is pretty amazing. So let's start the final episode. Is my camera not centered? There we go. Okay.
I mean, your eyes and the teeth. You're not really supposed to do that, are you?
Not if I can avoid it.
Holly's sister, Lily.
Do you even give a shit about us, the strays?
That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
We're destroying the tree. No!
We're not burning the tree, Snow.
Hey. You're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you.
And then Bigby gets shot.
Oh God, Bigby!
Ow!
This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart. And the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Okay.
Bigby, wait. When you get the crooked man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
All right. That was the whole start of the episode. Yeah, no build-up, just... Oh, I bumped my microphone a little bit. Also, I am still sick. Hopefully I'm better and can go back to work soon, but for right now, I can't because I work with children and they have weak immune systems. Not that you guys are at any risk, because it's not like you can get germs through a face cam and YouTube video. It's fine. Anyway, episode 5, Cry Wolf.
You've come a long way. You must be tired. And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently. Please, Sheriff, relax for a moment, will you?
Yeah, if you notice, the mural on the back is how the,
Something to eat. Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin.
Got a scotch?
Only Tennessee whiskey, unfortunately.
Oh. The Crooked Man may be a villain, but he
what
is a proper gentleman.
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey.
Yeah, sit down.
Sheriff, for the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You know why I'm here. You killed those women.
What women?
Faith and Lily.
I'm getting a call from Pennsylvania. I'll just,
Did I know? I assume by your confidence in accusing me, you must have some proof of this, yes? Some allotment of evidence. A witness, perhaps.
Your servant over there told me you did it.
That's a fucking lie! I didn't say anything like that.
It's fine.
All I said was that this was your town, and nothing wouldn't happen without your approval. All right? That's it.
Yeah, sure you did.
Those women. I don't relish telling you that the killings were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally. I just want to settle the issue for you and to assure you that it's over with. You really don't need to worry yourself further.
Okay, but who did it?
Fortunate bit of business. You're gonna tell me right now who killed him.
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information.
Please tell me.
You shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation? The man said he'd take care of it. So why don't you take the hint and get out?
I'm the law here, not you.
Yeah.
Now tell me who did it.
You think I'm scared of you? You're nothing more
than a... That's enough. I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but in the interest of preserving our alliance... If you have to know, it was Georgie.
Of course it was Georgie. Who else would it be?
Like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie.
You got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down now.
Yeah, I killed him, so what? You should have just kept your nose where it fucking belonged.
Why'd you do it? Why kill them?
Does it matter?
It kind
of
does.
The fact is, George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. But you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
Mm-hmm.
This is right bollocks, sis.
Georgie, shut up.
I'm just gonna let him do this.
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
What the hell?
Take this fucker. Take all of them. I didn't fucking
Don't
start
this.
Don't
make any trouble, Georgie.
Are you seriously throwing me under the fucking carriage?
All right, let's talk.
I
you
won't.
Can't
I'm
just
interested.
Hand me over. What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions. Not
Good point.
Murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You think I give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers
Just
are?
Get the fuck out of here!
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him! Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen.
What are you saying?
Yeah, what the fuck? You're gonna make sure we all go down this shitter with you?
I told you!
I'm not going anywhere.
This could have gone so well.
It could have, but it didn't.
To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
And here comes Bloody Mary.
Did I miss anything good?
No.
Well, look at you, all fixed up.
I tried to do this peacefully, but that's not what happened. I went for the one closest because... I think I just broke a window. Sorry, Crooked Man, I'm sorry. I'll pay for the damages once you get out of jail.
You're done, Wolf!
Come on, we're pretty much done here.
I'd like to say it was nice knowing you, but I'll be glad to see your insides turned out.
It's locking up a lot. Damn it, Georgie! I was willing to do things peacefully. And then the Crooked Man snapped his fingers and just messed me up. We'll see all these guys again, I'm sure. If they make a season 2. Given all the open ends that this one particular game has, I wouldn't be surprised if they did make a season 2, but they haven't yet.
Come on, George.
Oh, shit!
I know.
Let's go crazy. Just follow the button prompts, Zack. Don't screw us up. Yeah. Yeah, there we go. Come on. Hi, Crooked Man. Bye, Crooked Man. Yeah, you can only get one of them. I'd rather go after the one that I would have preferred to have gone after the one that actually killed the women, if you don't mind. Surprise, surprise, he went back to the pudding and pie to recover. Kind of a predictable move, Georgie. Just saying. And the game's locked up. Up, there it goes. And just saying, kind of a predictable move. No. Oh, sorry. Sometimes you just gotta sneeze.
Come on. We can't stay here.
Hang on. I need a minute.
Okay. How did this happen, Georgie? How did it... Can you stand up? It's okay. Take your time. Slowly.
Oh, it's no fucking use. No way I'm walking out of here. Well, it won't be your fault. It'll all land on me. Oh, fuck.
Here.
All right. Hi, pal. How you doing?
Shit.
My pop filter's...
Hello, baby.
Not centered. Hi.
I hope you'd come to your senses. Crooked Man's the one you want. But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
I'm taking you in, Georgie. Let's go.
You gonna carry me?
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
You can't seriously want to protect this guy. You know what he did.
I'm not going anywhere. It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Good point.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all
mistakes?
Have...
What?
He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then.
I didn't mean...
You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to...
My ass, he didn't have a choice.
You can't fucking blame me for that.
Look, I
sometimes you just have to do what you're told.
You didn't have to do anything.
Like hell I didn't. Look... Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the Crooked Man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Cause it's not my fault. The Crooked Man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out.
You're still the one who pulled the trigger. Nobody held your hand and made you go through with it.
Fair point.
Believe what you want. I can tell you've made up your mind. Doesn't matter if it's fucking true or not. Go ahead and arrest me then. But it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing. It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault.
I didn't say it was your fault. I just said I was blaming you.
What was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know? At the end of the day, you're just like him. Coming here, talking about options. Like it was that simple.
They could have let him go.
You could have done anything else. You could have let them go. You could have freed Faith and Lily from those fucking ribbons instead of murdering them.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them... What would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die. Do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you doing?
What are you talking about?
Yeah, I want to know.
Original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off. Couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here, either.
Wait.
Wait. Those were your ribbons? You're in on this? I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand, nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started, anyway.
Okay.
This was supposed to be our place. We were going to be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the Crooked Man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her, then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell. Save the fucking day.
Stop it.
We'll find another way. She doesn't have to die. Maybe the witches can...
Don't talk about me like I'm not even here. Please. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say? It's my life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
You're right. It's your life.
Yeah.
I know what I've done.
Wait.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here. But it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily? To all of them?
Vivian, wait.
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them. What I took away from them.
Yikes.
I look at Nerissa and I hate myself.
Vivian.
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Vivian, don't. Goodbye, Vivian.
Georgie.
No. Fuck. No.
Yui.
Why'd you have to do that, Vivian? Vivian! Shit!
Just... Jesus.
She didn't have to kill herself. Jesus Christ. Forgot Vivian, that happens.
I didn't fucking mean it. I was just... Oh.
Ew.
Get up. Get up.
Don't think so, Bigby.
You.
I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the Crooked Man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right? For both of us.
Don't worry about the Crooked Man.
He'll get what's coming to him later.
Old foundry by the river, all right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You wanna finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you wanna do, right? Well, whatever it is, just get it over with. I'm not sticking around for much longer.
That's not who I am.
Prove it, then. No more games, all right? We both know how this ends.
Poor Georgie.
Just make it quick. I know what I did.
I'll kill him because he's gonna...
Georgie.
Because he's going to die slow, painful death. If you don't. I had to. It would end his suffering. He didn't. I mean, he killed those women, but he didn't deserve to suffer. Nobody's coming in here anytime soon. That's for sure. Shepherd Metalworks, where the Crooked Man is hiding out. Knock, knock.
Of course.
Am I gonna have to break the door down? Come on, Crooked Man. You wanted to be civil at the beginning. Why did that change? Maybe I should grab Georgie from the beginning.
So this is where they've been sending these.
Don't these usually require a two men to open? Apparently not. But I know they're like really heavy and close and hard to open.
Big B Wolf.
Howdy. I'm the sheriff. Mary, come out.
You used to be something.
I still am something. I'm the guy who's gonna kick your ass and take your boss in for questioning. I don't know who I'm. I don't know who this middle girl is. That's Faith. That's Narissa, but who that? But who that? Who that? That's probably a glamour for Lily. Just to take a guess.
They used to fear you.
Are you sure they still don't?
They hide anywhere their small shivering bodies would fit.
Eey. That's some medieval torture right there. Mary, where are you? Come out so I can kick your ass. Please.
Silver.
The big bad wolf.
I hear ya, but I don't see ya. Oh shit, there she is.
It's about time you showed up.
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you made it here in one piece.
Hi.
I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you finish, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way now. Don't make this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Hey, I'm talking to you!
Didn't your mother ever teach you manners? Or was she too busy fucking whatever breeze drifted through town? This is just sad.
Mary? Ouch. I hear you. How was anybody supposed to react fast enough to do that? Jesus Christ. That's a cool character design, though. She's like glowing. She's filled with shards. Glass. Froze up. There we go. And we're in full wolf mode. Well, werewolf mode at least. Woof. This is creepy. It's time. Come on, Biggie. Yeah. That's the actual Big Bad Wolf. Time to mess some people up. This is Bigby's true form. Not the half-man, half-wolf state that we've been seeing. This is why Bigby is sheriff. This moment right here. Yeah. It's time for the true power of the Big Bad Wolf. Yeah, he'll huff and he'll puff and he'll blow the shit out of you. And she's dead. We never see her again. She got her shit pushed in by the Big Bad Wolf. She is dead. Bigby don't mess around. He don't. And he's shirtless. Oh, there's the shirt. Hi! Yeah, you saw all that? Well, same thing's gonna happen to you. Oh, it's frozen. Ah, oh, there we go.
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
This gun holds 6 rounds of specially designed.
I won't miss next time.
Okay.
Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want.
That's right. But what happens to you once you get there is a different story.
I'm not quite finished. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial.
The whole town will be calling for your execution. Why would you want me to bring you back there?
Good point.
Let me worry about that. Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women. And I think you know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
Maybe you didn't carry it out. But I don't think Georgie was lying when he said you ordered their deaths.
Georgie would have said anything to save himself. We both know that. I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
A lot.
As long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. I don't mean to belabor the point, but just so we're clear, if you change your mind and decide to do something stupid, you won't get your answers, but you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth, or do you just want to look like the hero?
This is about protecting Fable Town. Some asshole murders two of our people. It's my job to bring them down.
Good point.
You know who murdered them. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in, but you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going? I'd rather not dawdle.
All right, let's go. Hand over the gun.
I think I'd rather hold on to it, if you don't mind. Wait. Hey! I'm sure Miss White will be pleased. Such a reliable pup. I understand why she'd want to keep you around.
You're under arrest. You'll be given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.
And now the Crooked Man stands trial. Fun. This is probably why one of my the Wolf Among Us is by far my favorite Telltale game, for reasons you'll see.
I know, but we have to do something. Are you fucking kidding me?
When is this thing happening?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to
throw stones at him. Hi.
He's back.
The Crooked Man.
Motherfucker.
Are you okay?
Lock and grin.
It's been hours. We were worried you'd run into some trouble. At the Crooked Man's place.
Well, he didn't make it easy.
What happened?
It doesn't matter. He's here. We got him.
We can talk about it later. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know... I'm just... glad you made it back in one piece.
So am I.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes, what are you waiting
for?
You
murderer.
You killed Lily.
Where
the fuck do you get off? You think you have the right to just do this to people? You're a fucking crook.
You should be ashamed. Everyone, can I have your attention?
Sure.
Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but... considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The Crooked Man is charged with the murder
as
of Faith and...
As I already informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Porgy who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie?
Georgie?
I don't mean to interrupt you, Miss White.
Georgie may have killed them, but you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well, where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yeah, Sheriff. Where is that rotten scoundrel now?
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not.
Well, where is he?
Sheriff?
Don't worry about it. It's done.
Justice has already been dispatched. Bigby executed him.
He's... what?
Dead. So you see, the culprit has been punished. There's no
That doesn't change anything. We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for. And
I
don't...
I was told I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
If you'd wait a moment.
Let her finish. Then you can have your say.
Got it?
If you insist.
Alright, let's do this.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolf.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts.
And resisting arrest.
Oh, yes. Now, is there anything you would like to say?
First of all, I had nothing to do with Faith and Lily, so you can strike that one from your little record book.
Yes, you did.
Like hell you did.
Stop the charade. We know you're involved.
Come on, it's obvious.
And there's all the other crap he's done.
I know you're responsible. You've been behind all of this from the beginning. So cut the shit.
We all know who you are. We know what you've
done. Just give it up already.
All right.
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government and, most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death, upon which your body will be committed to the witching
where it fucking belongs.
That's
so
right.
Let's get on
but
with
we
it.
We promised
then.
You a chance to defend yourself, and I won't rob you of that right.
What the
you
fuck?
Really
this
to let
is
him
about
talk?
Justice. If we're ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly. No more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
Good point.
This is ridiculous.
You have the floor.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Oh, geez.
Are you gonna get to your point or what?
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure only he could understand, he murdered two of his most faithful employees. I had nothing to do with it.
This is such bullshit!
He's always been a bit of a powder keg.
Georgie seemed pretty convinced he didn't have a say in the matter.
He clearly misunderstood my intention.
Really?
I would never authorize such an act.
Any of you actually believe this bullshit?
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
What's he talking about?
Helpful isn't the word I would use.
My comrades are another matter. And I'm sorry for the predicament they put you in. They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me, as I protected them. You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you? You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man, just to save someone.
Yeah, right. They don't do it because they want to protect you. You intimidate people. You scare tactics. They're afraid if they don't follow orders, they'll end up dead.
Let me explain.
That's a good point.
My employees are just that. Hired help. I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
You're not serious.
My control died.
I know what you do to people. I've seen it firsthand. What you did to Faith, the way you manipulated her. Do you really think any of those girls were free? Do
nope.
you really think Faith
I'm
wanted
sorry,
to?
I'm sorry, Lawrence. I'm sorry that your wife came to me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my best judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah. That's what you did to us. How you kept us all
you
in line.
You forget it was not me who put you in that position.
Yes, it was.
Like I'm some kind of tyrant.
Yes, you are.
The government abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners. I was there to look out for you.
Yes, but...
Wasn't I?
We didn't abandon anyone. We've been trying to help them.
Really? What about Auntie Greenleaf? Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
I got her tree back. And in turn, we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself. And what did they do?
She wanted my tree destroyed, but Bigby refused.
What?
You were gonna burn her tree? Snow, why would you want that?
Is that true?
Snow?
Don't blame Snow, she had her reasons. Greenleaf was using her magic to help Crane and the Crooked Man. That's why Snow wanted your tree burned.
That's not why.
It wasn't her fault.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with a crooked man.
We've made some mistakes. I've made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town.
Do you?
And that may not always be clear right away. But I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
Yeah, right.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can. But I can promise to always have your best interests at heart.
Things haven't been great for a while now, but we'll do better at protecting you from people like him.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you, exploiting your hope for a better life. You would
he
go
exploits
to him
everyone.
For help, and he would take that weakness and add it to his strength. And if things didn't fall exactly his way, someone would die.
Do you really think the Crooked Man cared about you? He just cared about your money. He cares about your obedience.
They're right.
You're all still afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over, and those girls will have their justice.
Very good, very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the...
Georgie was working for you! Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke.
This guy knows the law a bit too well.
History.
What are you talking about? And what about your history? All you've done to this fucking town.
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. I just...
Of course it's right. This man tormented all of you, for profit. Georgie killed him.
Let me just make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
Yes.
Of course. Yes, you're responsible.
If I'm to blame for Georgie's mistakes, shouldn't Miss White be held accountable for Bigby's actions as well?
Like what?
How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody? He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my watch?
Maybe he's right. Did you think we'd all just let that go?
That was Bluebeard, not me.
He was a murder suspect.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection.
Protection, oh, my ass.
Dear, Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employees' behavior, but I must perish for
this
mine.
This is completely different.
Did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own
this
crimes.
This is right.
Oh, please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you.
Listen,
Everyone calm down. This isn't the reason
we're here.
I mean,
a certain level of privilege should be afforded to
them. This is how it's always been.
This is what I'm talking about. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since, which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be
Bigby? Miss White!
Plot twist!
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath, little
What's she doing here?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Bluebeard.
Of course. Go right ahead.
Say it.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come here.
My dear, I don't...
Just shut up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Be quiet.
Vivian killed herself back at the Pudding and Pie.
I'm sorry, I don't think I...
Nerissa! My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me.
And this just confirms it.
Yes, it does.
Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty.
Good enough for me.
Me too.
So that's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves!
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy?
You know we can't let you go free after this.
What did you expect to happen here? You're getting what you deserve.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's not good enough.
There will be more if he isn't stopped.
I don't care.
So we get rid of him.
It's too dangerous.
We can send him
away. Everyone, listen up! Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment, so I think
this is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
We should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right.
Nobody can agree on anything.
What about Bigby?
What about him?
He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine.
Are you sure? This isn't how
it's what the people want, Miss White.
Okay. Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Snow.
Just do what you think is right.
Yes, Sheriff. Do what you think is right.
Everyone, I'm...
Not this way!
In this guy.
Ah, there you are. I hope you all remember this moment. Think of me when you try to sleep.
You said you had a way to keep him from hurting people.
Wait, you can't be
what
serious.
What he's done? You're just gonna put him in prison?
This isn't the way, Sheriff.
You're doing the right thing.
Yes, there's a way.
It's about doing the right thing.
Do it.
Because I've seen both options where you execute him, and they both suck. So, locking him up is the only reasonable action. Besides, I like the Crooked Man. He's not so much evil as he is morally ambiguous. He's a crow.
Not what I was expecting. Morning, crooked man.
He's got a sharp tongue. I thought it would be better for everyone if he parted with it.
Thanks, Greenleaf.
Let's just call it even.
Hey, Sheriff.
Hi.
Come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
Yeah, he's a bird.
This fucking line.
We're working on it. We're working on it. So many unemployed people because the crooked man's a bird.
Oh, Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Yeah, she's a bit busy.
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
Colin just casually sneaking through the lobby. Great. I love that. But that scene with the Crooked Man is why this game is my favorite, because all the other games, they are manipulated based on your actions, but in this game, somebody actually calls them all out.
I'm going! Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
Carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit!
You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day.
Tried to help you.
Shit! Just go grab that, would you?
Sorry about all this. I tried to help.
I did.
Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance. But Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway. I told her I had the money, but she didn't want to hear it.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby, I have
to... And there's the Crooked Man.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so... If you could bring it to her, she was nice.
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
That's actually kind of cool.
She'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
I want one of those for my room now.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
Your dad broke the rules, TJ. You're not allowed to stay in Fabled Town without a glamour.
Okay.
Come on. It won't be so bad.
It won't be.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby! Where's your friend, Colin? Where's the fucking pig?
How should I know?
Yeah, the Crooked Man goes to stay at the farm. Hi. He is treated like the animal he is.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh, yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
You need to let that go. How are you going to move on?
Bigby, I know you're trying to help. But this is just something I need to do on my own. Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
Okay.
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily.
I'm
not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good.
Oh, did you?
Then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they go just to silence someone who had physical evidence?
It's okay. Just calm down.
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
You were just trying to protect them.
Yeah. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man.
And it didn't work out that way.
Oh, God. I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this, not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough.
I guess it worked out in the end. I can't hold that against you.
I know he...
Nobody can.
I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... That night, after Faith, I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her, just hoping that maybe if I couldn't save them...
You were trying to get my attention. So you...
Mm-hmm.
You started all this.
I just...
And she ended it.
...pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just... fade. Like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith. Or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
That's not true.
It is. You've just never seen it before. But now you have. You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her. Or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
Mm-hmm.
I feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other. And look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
I don't really know where we stand anymore. Things are just...
Sorry, friend. Sorry, allies.
Things are always different. Look, Bigby. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You knew when to show mercy, And you brought justice to this town, finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I hope I've at least done some good.
Mm-hmm.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you.
Got a point.
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
Before.
You're trying to place me.
Do you like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too.
Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for. I'll see you around, Wolf.
Yeah, you can choose by either to go after her or let her go. I chose to go after her because there's clearly more story there. Not that we're ever going to see it because they still haven't come out with a part two to this. But! Anyway, I kill Georgie. I let the Crooked Man have a trial. I imprisoned him. Accepted Cheese Day's gift. My last words to Nerissa were, I hope I done some good. Okay. Special stats. You offered him protection. You fought him after the interrogation. You gave him a drink. Alright, these are all the decisions. Okay. But anyway, that was The Wolf Among Us. I am sad. It is over now. What am I going to play next? I'll probably finish up whatever it's called. King's Quest. I'll just play hour-long sessions of that until I finish episode 5, and then I will have to find something else to do with my Thursday nights. But anyway, what did you guys think of this? Let me know in the comments below. Also, I love that whole ending with the Crooked Man there, where he just pointed out all your choices. He was like, you did this, you did this. I didn't do any of this. You did this. That was amazing. They should have made him a lawyer. That should have been the end. That should have been the option. He should have been a lawyer, but he should have been under probation or something like that. That should have been an option. Cause he kind of is a lawyer in a way. Like, that was the kind of whole design of his character. It was like he knew the law. He was both a loan shark and a lawyer rolled in the one. He was a lawyer shark. Yeah. Anyway, what you guys think of that series? Let me know in the comments below. I said that already. What am I saying? But anyway. Anyway, there's another Telltale game I am looking forward to. It's Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy, the Telltale series. That's gonna be fun. Hope you guys are excited for that. Oh. So there's more stories. Okay, well, if you want to know how the rest of this story goes, then there you go. There you go. Just pick a story. Oh, fuck. Just pick a comic and start reading. I mean, I'm definitely going to go down to my local comic shop and pick up some of these, so I suggest you do so as well. But anyway, I think I am going to leave the episode here. So, thank you so much for watching this episode. If you liked it, hit that like and that subscribe button. Also, be sure to follow me on Facebook and on Twitter in the description below. And until next time, I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.